Today I'm going to talk about how to store GPT tokens in cookies with GraphQL Next.js server using both GraphQL Playground and Polo Angular client. We use GPT tokens, especially refresh tokens, in order to allow users not to pass login and password again and again when they visit our websites. We have to store the GPT tokens somewhere, and the most popular tools are the local storage and the cookies. Why we have to use the cookies instead of the local storage? The main reason is the cookie is not accessible via JavaScript. If you are using HTTP only and secure cookies, you can use a lot of external third-party libraries in your website. So the possible attackers can just take the token that you stored in your local storage. I will leave the link to this useful article in the description below. This is my GraphQL Next.js server application. First of all, we have to add the incoming request to the GraphQL context in order to access it from resolvers. Then we add the course configuration object for the XHR request. Now we are applying the cookie parser middleware as a global middleware. Then we enable the course policy for the pre-flight requests. Also, I will leave the link for the course configuration options in the video description below. This is a login by email mutation, which returns tokens, both access token and refresh token. I am going to store the access token in in-memory database, but the refresh token will be stored in the cookies. We have to moderate the login by email mutation. You can pause the video. Also, I will leave the link to the cookies options. In order to use the cookies in your playground, we have to add some settings. Also, I will leave the link in the video description below. Now we can see the refresh token is stored in the cookies. And now we can access the refresh token from the request. And now the refresh access token mutation will work without authorization headers. This is my Angular client application, and now we have to make the Apollo client request to make with credentials true. The link also in the description below. I hope this video was useful for you. Please give thumb up, and thank you for watching. Bye bye.